I don't deny that this growing sense of frustration of the widening gap between the rich and the poor does not exist. I think it does exist, and I'm the first person to want to do something about it and like to see something done. But now let's get back to the point about the demonstrations. I mean, if you think that that is the real reason why they're doing it, then where's the point about the democracy? Are you saying that the
democratic government is probably Hong Kong's best defense against that sort of cronyism and unaccountable corruption?
The only problem is that idealistically it sounds good on paper, but you look at Britain, for example. It's got a very good democratic system. It doesn't look as if it's corrupt and so forth, but is it efficient? A lot of people will say it is not as efficient. You point to any other country, it's not that as long as you have a Western democratic free system, free from cronyism and so forth, that is going to work like paradise. There isn't a place like that in the world. And if you don't find cronyism, you probably do find it if you search long enough. I mean, that's the whole problem. Everything is a bit relative in a way, and Hong Kong is not too bad. And I just pray we don't throw away what we have at the moment.